So here we have a Maxus eDeliver 3 electric van. These are also called the Maxus EV30 in other markets. And in this video, I'm just going to show you how you identify what battery pack these have got. If you're looking to buy one of these second hand and the owner doesn't know the pack, or it's not advertised with the pack size. And these in the UK come with either a 35 kilowatt hour pack underneath the floor there, or a 52.5 kilowatt hour pack. So when a manufacturer offers different sized battery packs on the same model, it is often very difficult to work out what battery is fitted to a particular model you're looking at, and the battery pack size isn't normally referred to in the V5. It's not part of the model naming of the car, and you also get no badges on the back telling you what size pack it is. So I'm going to go through the various ways you can tell, and also the pitfalls of using some of those, and show you how you tell what size battery pack is fitted to a Maxus eDeliver 3. So the first method that most people are going to use is have a look at the range meter. So on the dash here, we can toggle around and we can see we've got 66 miles of range, and there's the battery state of health, but this doesn't show whole battery. When that's up at the top, that's not actually 100%. So we can also push the button here and we can toggle around to state of charge. So 70%. So on this vehicle at 70%, we've got 66 miles of range, so you can work out that this one is a 35 kilowatt hour pack. However, this isn't a particularly accurate way of doing it, because the estimated range is obviously an algorithm and it's based on how the vehicle was driven. So you might get one of these with a larger pack and it might still be showing the same sort of range if it's been driven inefficient recently. So you can't rely on what the guessometer says, particularly if the van's been sat for a long time or has been running, or they've left it running with a heater on while they're valeting it or cleaning it or whatever. That can often drop this down significantly and be a very inaccurate way of working that out. However, if the battery is fully charged and it is at 100%, if you toggle this round to the estimated range, if it's showing a range of 100 miles, then it's most likely the 35 kilowatt hour, and if it's showing a range of about 150 miles, then it's most likely the 52 kilowatt hour. And the differences between the two vans, the 35 kilowatt hour, as this one is, will do anything from 100 to 150 mile range, and typically the 52 kilowatt hour model will do anything from 150 to 200 miles range. But as always, it does depend on how the van has been driven and what it's been doing recently. But if it's showing 100%, then that is usually a pretty good way of telling what battery it's got. Another way is you can look at the VIN number here on the screen, or the V5. So obviously, when you're dealing with VINs, you can get the VIN number of a vehicle you're looking to buy from a data lookup, or obviously you can ask the seller and or get a photograph of the VIN plate here on the windscreen. So I've been looking up VIN numbers of both the 52 and the 35 kilowatt hour vans, and I'm not 100% sure here, but I think I've come up with the differences. So the I think it's the ninth character in, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, yes. The ninth character in this case is 2, and then the next 2, this is a 2LA. I think 2LAs are 35 kilowatt hour battery packs, but 3MA is the 52 kilowatt hour packs. So if you've got one of these vans, can you have a look at your VIN and see whether that works for your vehicle, and let me know in the comments below. So if that VIN method works and the 52s are a 3MA and the 35s are a 2LA, then that's going to be the easiest method to work out the battery pack in one of these, because you can always get the VIN number if you're buying a vehicle remotely. Another method is to look at the vehicle weight, and that is declared on the V5. And looking at this one, we've got revenue weight, which is Y, and in this case it's 2,460 kilograms, and we've also got mass permissible weight, again it's the same, and mass in surface is the same. And I find this a lot, is whoever registers the van when it's new, they make mistakes with all of this. And I don't just find it on the Maxus, I find it on all vans. These weights are always wrong, and in this case it is wrong. They're all wrong, in this case, and also the braked towing weight and unbraked towing weight are also wrong on this vehicle by a long, long way. And what I found is they're actually using the weights for the 52 kilowatt hour van, but I've got it all wrong anyway. But anyway, the weight of the vehicle for the 52 kilowatt is 2460, and that's what this one says. So you can't rely on that, but there is a way. You can't obviously do that from the V5, but there is a way, because the weights are put on the sticker on the door plate. So I'll go around there and show you that. So on the passenger door here, you have the sticker here with the VIN number and all the weights. And if you can get the seller to give you a photograph of that, then you can tell what size battery pack it has. So this sticker is right, whereas the V5 is normally wrong. So that top weight there, where it says 2,310 kilograms, shows that it is the 35 kilowatt hour van. If that was 2,460 kilograms, it would have the 52 kilowatt hour battery. So using this sticker as a reference is going to be your most accurate way of telling, because the van with the bigger battery weighs more. The other method is to crawl underneath and have a look at the actual battery pack, which I'll show you now. So I'm on the passenger side, near side, and if you get your head down behind the tyre here and look up at the battery pack, you can actually see the sticker. So here's the battery pack, and just up there is the sticker that gives you all the battery information. So I hope that helps. If it has, please do click the thumbs up button on YouTube. That really does help. It allows other people to find the channel, helps me out as well. Also subscribe if you're not, and if you want to see more videos on these vans, the Maxus eDeliver 3 or the EV30, then I'll put a link below in the video description to a playlist, and you can see other videos I've made on these vans.